The content of the next video is a song called The Absent Minded Beggar, based on a poem by Rudyard Kipling and set to music by Sir Arthur Sullivan. The song was written as part of an appeal by the Daily Mail to raise money for soldiers fighting in the Second Boer War and their families. The fund was the first such charitable effort to raise funds for war. The song invited the audience to pass the hat for credit's sake and pay, pay, pay. Huge quantities of the poem and music copies were sold, along with other merchandise, to aid a charity, the Absent Minded Beggar Fund, which raised an historic sum of £250,000. Many of the men who fought in this campaign were volunteers who had given up well-paid civilian jobs to take the Queen's shilling, which was a big drop in their family income and often created hardship. The fund was used to alleviate their hardship, together with support for homecoming and injured soldiers. This huge charitable effort has since been referred to as a major factor in the origins of the welfare state. You shouted, "Rule Britannia," when you sung "God Save the Queen." When you finished killing Kruger with your mouth, would you kindly drop a shilling in my little tambourine for a gentleman in khaki ordered south? He's an absent-minded beggar and his weaknesses are great, but we and Paul must take him as we find him. He's out on active service, wiping something off a slate, and he's left a lot of little things behind him. Duke's son, Cook's son, son of 100 kings, 50,000 horse and foot, going to Dable Bay, each of them doing his country's work, and who's to look after their things? Pass the hat for credit's sake, and pay, pay, pay. There are girls he married secret, asking no permission to, for he knew he wouldn't get it if he did. There is gas and coals and victuals and the house rent falling due, and it's more than rather likely there's a kid. There are girls he walked with casual, they'll be sorry now he's gone, for an absent-minded beggar they will find him. But it ain't the time for sermons with the winter coming on. We must help the girl that Tommy left behind him. Cook's son, Duke's son, son of a belted earl, son of a Lambeth publican, it's all the same today. Each of them doing his country's work, and who's to look after the girl? Pass the hat for credit's sake, and pay, pay, pay. There are families by the thousands far too proud to beg or speak, and they'll put their sticks and bedding up the spout, and they'll live on half of nothing paid them punctual once a week, 'cause the man that earned the wage is ordered out. He's an absent-minded beggar, but he heard his country's call, and his regiment didn't need to send to find him. He chucked his job and joined us, so the job before us all is to help the home that Tommy left behind him. Duke's job, Cook's job, gardener, baronet or groom, muse or palace or paper shop, there's someone gone away. Each of them doing his country's work, and who's to look after the room? Pass the hat for credit's sake, and pay, pay, pay. Let us manage so as later we can look him in the face and tell him what we very much prefer, that while he saved the empire, his employer saved his place, and his mates, that you and me, looked out for her. He's an absent-minded beggar, and he may forget it all, but we do not want his kiddies to remind him that we sent them to the workhouse while their daddy hammered Paul. So we'll help the home that Tommy left behind him. Cook's home, Duke's home, home of a millionaire, 50,000 horse and foot going to Table Bay, each of them doing his country's work, and what have you got to spare? Pass the hat for credit's sake, and pay, pay,